Welcome to my little experiment box. Today I'm going to be showing you how to mix and correct paint that is too thin. This is a problem that I think a lot of us run into, where we just get overzealous or something doesn't go right with our formula or the formula we're using off the internet, and our paint ends up too thin. So here I've made some really thin white paint, like super white, super liquidy. Now to remedy this paint, I am going to mix some Golden Heavy Gel Gloss with some Floetrol. And this is going to give us a thicker little medium that we can use to thin out or thicken up our paints. The reason we want to mix it with the Floetrol first is because we really need to have a consistency that is closer and more fluid than the gloss medium comes in. So I'm going to show you on a popsicle stick, and I'll try to show you just in the container. It's a pretty thick substance. And so I'm going to take about that much. And I'm going to pop it in a little cup. And I'm going to shake my Floetrol a little. I think I want a little bit more than that. About that much. And I'm going to take my Floetrol that I have shaken well and add this in with that, just about that much. And we're going to mix those two together before we add them to our super runny paint. Let me put my lid back on mine. This heavy gel gloss is used kind of for doing impasto paints, where you want to make surface texture and things of that nature when you're painting. Now you're going to see that this is really clumpy to start out. And essentially this is a heavy body paint that has no color. You also can find just colorless paint. There's a couple different brands that sell it. I will look some up at the moment. I can't remember exactly which ones I've seen it in and which ones I haven't. So I don't want to start saying stuff and sounding stupid. But it's really lumpy right now. So I'm going to pause the video for just a few minutes, and we're going to let this sit for about 5 minutes so that, I want it mixed in as well as I can before I do that. So a much better consistency. And let me get a little cup to put white in. Here's our overly runny white, which has some chunks in it. That's just lovely. I picked up the wrong cup of white. This one I had mixed some of the heavy body in directly earlier. So let me get rid of those chunks before we mix anything else into this. So I totally picked up the wrong paint, but it is still too runny. So I'm going to take some of this, add it in here, and we're going to stir it around and see what we get. We put two dollops. It's a very technical term. I'm sure if you look it up, it actually is a technical term, and someone can tell you exactly how much is in a dollop. And this is probably less than that. But I'm using it as a relative term. Okay, so the paint is already a much better consistency than it was just a minute ago, and I will show you with the pour off the stick very elastic now. It's actually a little thicker than I want, so we will use just a drop or two of water. Just five, not one or two, five, to thin that back down to a good pouring consistency. Okay, I'll do this the easy way and use just a little more of my runny white paint so that we don't waste it either. And stir that into here. All right, much better consistency for pouring with. And you can see the Floetrol and heavy gel makes a very thick pudding-like. Okay, so we're gonna pour some of our white that we have thickened up in here. I'm gonna pour some of this ugly crap I mixed here to the side. I do not see me ever using this color again, by the way. Same as this one. It is going to be even more Christmassy than I imagined. I might just take a blue that I already have pre-mixed with the same mixture and squirt this in here. Oh, worse. These colors are just getting worse and worse. And something to brighten it up a little, because I hate this. This is ugly. And I hope that this gets better. And a little more white. Okay, I'm gonna take a clean stick here and I'm just gonna give this like three stirs and then a pull across and a pull across. Just to give it a nice little stirred consistency so that maybe something happens and we get to see some magic. Cause we all love the magic. Show me the money spot. Show me the money shot. I got something on that tile. I really don't care. I only test on these. Please be prettier than I think you are going to be. Let's see what we've got right there. Still ugly. I don't know what I'm doing, but we will try to make this look a little better, like it's a lullaby. Maybe it will turn out okay if I pray. Let's we've got there. I think the yellow and the orange may have saved it. As you can see, we are getting some cell activity popping up here, here, here. Usually with this formula, I get quite a bit of cell activity, so I'm gonna say it does hinder cells to an extent. Let me try to get this stupid torch that I have way too much paint on. Oh, I wish I could just break this little thing off and keep it where this was a dangerous, dangerous thing to have in my office. But I don't need any more dangerous things than I already have. And here we go. Let's see what we get. There's no silicone. Usually I don't use silicone for anything, because I don't like it. I don't like having to deal with it. I don't like having to figure out how to get it to do what I want it to. Getting some pretty lacing right here after torching. If I was to continue torching right here, I know I would get more lacing, which we're going to go for if it comes on. Yay! So we'll get some more lacing right in here. Bring some of that yellow or something up through there. It should just a test anyway, so I really don't care how it turns out, other than the colors, because the colors were hideous. And we will do one more here, and we'll test it with a dirty pour. I'm gonna just use the same dirty cup from that because I don't care. And we're gonna pour some of this white in there. What can I do with my ugly red? Here's my ugly red. And some of my pretty blue. And some of this pretty orange. These colors are gorgeous. I think I added some yellow. Any other? Pour a little of this green into that blue. Maybe that'll make the green a little better. A little more of that white on top. Just a swirl. Grab our little stick. Two, across, and across. And we'll try this one as a dirty pour. Because why not? And let's see. Definitely some cell activity. Since that paint's a little fresher than this was, we will go ahead and try just torching it while it's still in big piles. That way we lose some of these ugly cells it makes and hopefully get it to leave something pretty behind as we tilt. I'm going to tilt this way first because I actually like that corner. And so I want to try to keep those, so I want that to be the first one that I tilt. Oh, we're getting some ugly crap. Really ugly crap. And I'll just try to let it run off until maybe it's not so ugly anymore. My hand is beautiful. Yes, again, I know I should be wearing gloves. I'm just going to go ahead and throw that out there that I am aware of the need. And I have a ton in here. This is kind of stress relief from my day, and so I need to feel the pain on my hands. Okay, got a lot more cell activity, a lot of lacing. I tilted it quite a bit just because I really hated those colors that were going on that other side. And even though it is just a test pour, it'd be cool if I could use it as something to throw up in the air and shoot my gun at. So that's what we got. It did thicken up the white paint enough that it made everything flow very well. It was more the consistency I needed it to be in order to match the consistency of the other paint. Gonna call that one done. I'm gonna edit some of these and hopefully get them up onto the interwebs. Because I'm great at making them and I'm awful at actually sharing them. Let's zoom in just a little so we can see what we got. The camera does not want to focus, so I'm going to pause. We will resume. I'm going to turn off the overhead light. And I will most likely seem drunk doing this. I am not. But this will at least show what activity we have in each one. You can see there's some really pretty cells with multiple dimensions coming up in both of these paintings. And when it's all said and done, I actually don't hate the color scheme. There's a cool dragon thing going on this side. So I hope that helps you some. Have a great day.